Good morning. My name is Jessica Pierce, and I am so thrilled that you all are here today. And we are excited to have you here, and you are in the right place at the right time. I am the founder and CEO of Career Connectors, and we are doing this program in partnership with the Greater Phoenix Chamber Foundation. And so what I would like you to do right now is open your chat icon on the bottom of your screen and drop in the chat, good morning, go ahead in, or afternoon, but tell us where you are calling in from and tell us what is your target job or career. We want to make sure you all are engaged today. If you have a LinkedIn profile, that is a great thing to drop in the chat as well so we can connect with each other. So drop in the chat icon on the bottom where you're joining us from and what type of position you are looking for right now. So again, this is a collaboration with the Greater Phoenix Chamber Foundation and Career Connectors. So we are located in Arizona, and that's our home base. And so the companies here today are Arizona-based companies. If you are calling in from somewhere else, then there are also opportunities for remote positions and relocation. So you are still in the right place, even if you are not living in Arizona at the moment. So I'm excited for you all to get to meet each other and meet our hiring companies. So a little bit, some tech stuff real quick before we get started. If you have any questions this morning, please drop them in the chat. We have some great moderators that are going to be in the chat answering questions. Our companies are on the line and they're going to be answering questions. And so we're really asking you to be engaged in the chat today, asking questions. The way that you want to look at your screen is called speaker view. So what that means is you're going to see the PowerPoint in front of you, which is important because it has all the company information on it, but then you're also going to see who is speaking. So on your screen, over towards the most of us, the top right-hand corner, there is a little icon that says view. If you click on that, you'll see side-by-side speaker. That is really the best view for an event like this. So you can see the PowerPoint and you can also see the person that is speaking. And at the end of this call, we're also going to go into breakout rooms. And so at that time, you're going to be able to unmute yourself. But during the call today, please keep yourself muted, and because it causes a lot of background noise. If you have questions, again, the chat is the place to go for any questions you have. So I am seeing some people saying good morning. Hi, Hugh. Good morning in Chandler and Mark. Good morning. I see somebody from Buffalo, New York, Luis from Phoenix. Good morning, guys. Hi, Andre from Levine. So glad you all are here. Please, if you're just jumping on, jump over to the chat. The chat icon again is on the bottom of your screen and say good morning. If you do need closed captioning, that option is also on the bottom of your screen. So we have a couple of people that have it enabled right now. So on the bottom of your screen, click show icons, or I think it says show captions. Yeah, show captions. Click on that. And so as we get started here, I just wanted to share a little bit with you guys on this program and how it got started. I just wanted to step back for a minute because there have been some significant layoffs in the last 2 weeks. And so I don't know if you are here because of a layoff. I don't know your story. I'm excited to get to know many of you. Many of you I do know, but I'm excited to get to know other people on the call. And I hope that we are able to provide some resources. But I just wanted to take a moment and share my personal story, because I think if you have gone through a layoff, you might relate to this. And I just want you to know we get it. We hear you, we understand, and we are here for you. Because when I started this program back 14 years ago, which is crazy to me, but 14 years ago, we were in the midst of the Great Recession. If you remember the Great Recession, can you just drop in the chat like, yeah, you got me. You remember the Great Recession. It was tough. Some of us are like, oh my gosh, I don't ever want to go back there again. But the Great Recession, yes, exactly. Thank you for the support. Thank you. thank you. Yeah. So first year selling cars, Rachel, wow. And so back in the Great Recession, I actually was running, originally was at Intel, had been at Intel for 10 years. And then they went through a huge, huge layoff of 10,000 people and it affected our entire department. So I got laid off, but at that time I launched a business that was in 2007 and ran a staffing firm and was really successful. We were just loving it. And we were working with clients that were in land development and commercial real estate. Then the Great Recession started happening in 2008. And by May of 2009, all of our clients had either closed the doors or had gone to very, very, very bare bones skeleton crews. And so we decided, the four partners decided to go ahead and close our staffing business. And so there I was all of a sudden not working. And my husband, who was a recruiter at that time as well, was laid off 3 times in 6 months from 3 corporations. So there we were in May of 2009, neither of us working. And I remember just looking around and going, how is this happening to us? And I don't understand. And so it was one of those moments of, oh my gosh. I mean, our kids at the time, we had an infant, a 2-year-old and a 10-year-old. You know, we had the house, we had the cars, we had all the stuff. And all of a sudden, no jobs. And so, you know, stewed over that, trying to figure out what we were going to do. And I went to bed one night and I woke up the next morning and I said, I got it. I am going to go volunteer. And my husband was like, what? We need money. What are you talking about? And I said, well, I don't know. I see all these people around me that don't have any idea about the next step forward. They've never looked for a job before and they don't know what to do and they feel frozen. And I said, at least I know how to pull together a resume, that I know how to network and make connections. And so that was the day that I said, I called my church up and I said, can I have a room in the back of the church for to help some people write some resumes? And they're like, yes, we are getting calls like crazy. And so through that started this movement and I pulled in some really good friends. One's on the line today, Denise Gredler. I said, I need help. I need to bring some companies in. And that is how it all started. And that was 14 years ago. And I can promise you this. I promise you, it was one of the best things that's ever happened to me and our family is for us to go through that layoff. Loved my work at Intel, loved the staffing firm, but I feel like being able to do this and serve our community is what I was called to do. It's my calling. And so I don't know where you are. I don't know if you're feeling like, I just need something different. I need to feed my family. I need to, and that's very real and true. Maybe you're in a place where you're like, it's time for me to find my legacy. It's time for me to do what God has called me to do, or whoever, whatever your belief system is, but whatever has, you know, it's your time. So whatever that is, I encourage you that it's going to be okay and you will get through this. And so you're going to hear from some great companies today that have fantastic opportunities. And I encourage you when we get to the breakout room session, section of the event, that you jump into each of those breakout rooms and you engage and you talk, because the way that you engage with people during these type of events and connect can set up a future that you didn't even know was there. So good morning. Thank you all for listening to my story. I am, again, so glad you are here. Here is what we have for you this morning. We're going to get started with the Greater Phoenix Chamber Foundation. They're going to give you an overview of this industry and what is going on. And then you're going to hear from all of these hiring companies that are listed. And they're going to talk for 5 or 7 minutes about their company, their culture, benefits, jobs, how to apply. And then at the end of that time, we're going to go into their breakout session. And that is when you get to network. So while these companies are talking, please drop in the chat anything, any questions you have, but also write some questions down. Make sure you have something to write down because you're going to take some questions or you're going to write some questions when these companies are talking, so that when you go into the breakout session, you can ask them direct questions about either jobs they have or culture or anything you want to ask them during that time. So it is my pleasure to introduce you to our first speaker, Jill Buschbacher. She is the Director of Workforce Innovation for the Greater Phoenix Chamber Foundation. Good morning, Jill.
Good morning. Great to have everyone today. Thank you for being here with us. So I'm just going to talk to you a little bit about Arizona and kind of some of the labor market information about this industry. There's a couple ways to slice and dice it. There's some good news. There's some information about entry-level jobs. So hopefully you find this informative and helpful and get something out of it. Some of it might be new to you. Some of you may be expert in it. But just wanted to share some stats and figures kind of about the local picture of this industry. So this slide just kind of tells you a little bit about some positive things about Arizona's economy. That we've had great population growth, employment growth, and labor force growth, which are all positive. A lot of states, just so you know, if you were to look at some others that we kind of compete with, don't necessarily have the same picture as far as their continually growing labor force and employment growth overall. So this is good news. This is kind of some of the long-term trends for our state. Next slide, please. So our overall employment is about 3 million people. And when you look at the U.S. Bureau of Labor Statistics and how they define jobs kind of in this sector, they call them transportation and material moving occupations. So there's a lot of ways, again, to slice and dice this data and to talk about these occupations, but just kind of giving you a flavor for where you can find some of this information and what some of the basic stats are. The mean wage, which is the average wage for Arizona for those occupations, is about $43,000. But you know, you have to figure that's including everything from soup to nuts. So that's including entry level all the way up to supervisory level. So there are definitely occupations within that pay at a higher level. And just kind of that's the average. So next slide, please. So another way to look at it is here's some information that comes from the U.S. Bureau of Economic Analysis, as well as some stats from Bureau of Labor Statistics, again, which are federal resources. The total number of jobs in this sector under this definition in Arizona is 603,000. We've had a pretty good growth rate over the last 10 years, but this last year was just a little bit lower. It averaged 3.1 throughout that time, but last year it was about 1.4%. And it's the fifth largest industry in our economy here in Arizona, so by number of jobs that it includes. So just to kind of let you know a little bit about where it sits in our Arizona economy. And then there's another way to look at it, all the different sectors and kind of the growth they've had over the last, the projected growth that they're expected to have over the next 10 years. 85,000 new jobs are projected between 21 and 31 in this sector, which is good news. So the third highest number of new jobs created of any large industries in Arizona. So you see healthcare, of course, is first, no surprise there. Professional and business services, and then trade, transportation, and utilities is how this is ranked. And this is from the Arizona Office of Economic Opportunity. If you haven't had a chance to kind of dive into some of the data information that they collect, that's where our state economists are. That's where you can learn a lot about what's going on in the Arizona economy. They put out a report every month, and and it's really just a good place to kind of find out what's going on in Arizona economic wise. Next slide, please. So some of the occupations that are projected to grow, here's just kind of a sampling of them in this industry and what the wages are. So material moving workers, of course, stockers and order fillers, drivers, laborers, heavy and tractor trailer truck drivers, as you see, as we mentioned. So just kind of gives you an idea. These are more of the probably entry to mid-level positions, but it's just kind of good to know what are the largest growing and what some of the projected growth rates are in some of these. Overall, about 67,000 jobs are expected to be created according to this data from the Bureau of Labor Statistics. So, next slide, please. And then, if you want to dive deeper into some of this information, you can look at our State of the Workforce report at our site with the Greater Phoenix Chamber Foundation. And then also, we'll have some specific target industry reports, including healthcare and cyber and construction and a variety of others that'll be posted on the site next month. So that'll be hot off the press, new information that you might find it just interesting. And so I just wanted to share that opportunity with you as well. And here's my contact information if you have any questions about the information that we've shared. And again, just welcome. Hope everyone gets a lot out of this event today and wish you well in all your career ambitions and goals. And thank you for your time again. I'll turn it
Awesome.
back to you, Jessica.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Jill. Thanks for being here and sharing the overview. And I know that the chamber also has a workforce summit coming up, so we'll even see more information coming out soon. So thank you for being here. Really appreciate it.
Thank you so much. Take
All
care.
right, now we're going to move into our hiring companies. And the first one we have on deck is Amazon. Jasmine Secon is a workforce development specialist. Good morning, Jasmine.
Good morning. Hi, everyone. Good morning. I'm just going to go ahead and start off with a little introduction. This way, you can get an idea of what like a career path can look like with Amazon. And then we'll go ahead and jump into the slides. But a little bit about myself. So, as Jessica mentioned, I am a workforce development specialist with the team here in oh gosh, Amazon. But I look over the Arizona market, but I'm based in California. I started off my career about 4.5 years ago as a coordinator on our local hiring team out in the Bay Area. From there, about a year later, I was promoted into the staffing specialist role. So there, I did a lot of more of like the background, so like making sure like all the requisitions for the sites are there, all the job postings, making sure like the pay, all the little details that go into like making sure everything is posted. I was involved heavily in that, as well as working really close with all the different sites, so like the managers, HR, making sure that we were planning for like all the different labor demand that was needed on a weekly basis. From there, I kind of shifted more into like the team side. So I was a staffing team lead. So I overlooked one of the hiring teams in the Bay Area. Love that. It's got to be really more on the personal side, helping with development for all the different employees and coordinators and administrators that we had, supporting the local hiring. And then from there, I came into the role I'm in now, which I've been in for the past 2 years, previously supporting the California Bay Area East Bay side. I took over Arizona recently, so in April. Haven't gotten used to the heat yet, but love all the different excitement and opportunities that we have and being able to provide the local communities with jobs. So perfect. Let's go ahead and jump into the slide that we have here. So just talking about hourly roles at Amazon. So we are hiring for tier one. So basically like the entry levels at our different warehouses. I'm sure everyone's seen at least one warehouse, if not more. We have plenty across the market, whether you're in Arizona or anywhere else outside of the state, pretty much everywhere. So all the different links that I am sharing, you can use them from wherever you are. All you have to do is just put in the zip code. But just talking about the position, so there is a lot of like stowing, packing, moving different boxes. You're going to be working with different like machinery, but they do teach you everything that you need to know. So everything is on the spot. You don't have to worry about having any type of background in this if you are interested. If you do have background, great. That will just help support you. And our jobs are great. Like if you're looking for something that's flexible, if you're looking for part-time, full-time, or maybe this is just your foot in the door so you can move up with the company, it's a great opportunity to do so. A lot of people that are managers or even like as high up as you want to go started off as like an entry-level position. Even on our local hiring team in Arizona, most of the coordinators there did start off in a local site. And then talking a little bit more, so some of the different warehouses that we have, they go from the really large ones that you might have seen, which are the fulfillment centers. Then we have delivery stations. We have fresh locations. They look just like a grocery store, but in a warehouse, so minus the customers. But exact same setup, they have all the different aisles, shopping carts, all that good stuff. And then we do have Caribou locations, which are a little more newer. It's all fully robotics. And then you're just kind of like working with those. And then we can go ahead and go to the next slide. Thank you. And if anyone is interested, this is a great link that you can go on. You can learn a lot more. It'll talk more about like our benefits and give you a little bit more details on that, what work-life balance looks like, all those different aspects. But this is the link. And like I mentioned, you can just go on here. And then if you just break it down by your zip code, it'll give you everything that's available. What's nice is it breaks it down based off of the different shifts that are available and the sites. So based off of like what location you prefer. So you can get the schedule that matches your like your everyday life at the best. And maybe you aren't ready to apply, you can always do the text alert. So if you text 77088 to Amazon, after that, it will just ask you if you're okay with getting like alerts and for your zip code. And then it will just narrow down jobs that are close to you that are open up. And then we can go to our last slide. And then we do have drop-ins available. So say you'd like to do an application, maybe you want to do it in person. The location that's listed on here is GYR1 in Goodyear. This is the location that our coordinators are always at. So we always have it open, whether it's Saturday or any day of the week. I recommend going on Saturday, anywhere from 10 to 1. Reason being is all of our shifts get posted on Friday. So this way you have that first opportunity. Or if you are using the link, same thing, I recommend hopping on Saturday morning. This way you can get as much as available so you can see exactly what works best for you. But thank you. If there's any questions, please let me know.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Jasmine. So Jasmine is also answering questions in the chat. There are a couple questions in there, Jasmine, so you'll want to jump over to the chat. And then also, she is available during breakout sessions. So make sure that you stick around. After the company speak, we will be going into our breakout sessions. All right, I would like to introduce you all to Vanessa McHugh. She is a recruitment coordinator for ADOT, Arizona Department of Transportation. Good morning, Vanessa.
Good morning, Jessica. Good morning, everybody. Thanks so much for having me. I'm excited to be back at another one of these awesome events. So as Jessica mentioned, I'm a recruitment coordinator here at the Department of Transportation. I'm going on about almost 3 years of being here, and I absolutely love it. I did come over from the private sector, so it's been quite the change, but a positive change working for the state here. So just a little bit of information about ADOT and kind of who we are. So we're obviously a transportation agency, and we serve one of the fastest growing areas of the country, as I think we've all seen, especially us natives. It's growing a lot. So we're responsible for planning, building, and then operating, obviously, all of the highway systems. And then the bridges in Grand Canyon Airport is a huge component of what we also contribute to. Another one I think we are all very much aware of, we've stepped foot in one, the motor vehicle division. So obviously, you know, we operate all of those all over the state. So you can imagine the different opportunities that we have and how many openings we're constantly getting. We process titles, registration, driver's license services. And then we currently employ about 3,500 people. I think it's obviously grown a little bit more with some of our openings right now. And a big thing here, and I can absolutely agree and say that we really do focus on a great work-life balance. That is a huge thing that we are trying to promote here working for the state. Our vision, as you can see, is moving Arizona to become the most reliable transportation in the nation. And then our mission is connecting Arizona, everyone, everywhere, every day. Next slide, please. So here I just featured a few of our positions. I just actually logged on our website and we have about 41 openings. So you can see already when I submitted this information back to 3 last week, I think it was, or a couple days ago, we only had 30 openings. And as of this morning, we already have 41. So it kind of gives you an idea of how often we open and close our job opportunities. So again, just a few that I'm featuring, we have our transportation construction technicians. Those positions are available throughout the entire state of Arizona. We kind of have them all over. So those are going to be working. Those are going to be more our labor intensive job opportunities. So you're going to be out on the highways, you're going to be operating heavy machinery. So for a lot of those positions, I actually saw somebody had dropped in that they do have a CDL. We do require a CDL for those positions. However, if you don't have it, but you come on board, you actually have 6 months to obtain it. And we do assist you through that process so that you are successful in getting that. We have transportation engineering specialists. These positions are going to kind of just be depending on the level. So we start anywhere from level 1 up to level 4. And they are going to be specific depending on where you're working. A lot of them are working, again, with the highways. You're going to be working with the soils, helping the engineers with the building and stuff and the construction. So we have all those details on our site, what that's going to entail. Another big one, as you can see, as I kind of mentioned, our MBD, right? I mean, that's what ADOT's really about, is the MBD. So we have a ton of these customer service representative positions. These are a good way to get your foot in the door with the state. So we start entry level, which is going to be our level 1. No experience is necessarily required. You're going to be working in our offices and you're going to be working with the general public on all those services. And then we go up to level 3 for this series. And then if you look below customer service rep 4, we also have specialty openings as well and management positions. So again, if you just want to get your foot in the door and you're looking to really start a career with ADOT, the entry-level positions are a great way to do that. We're always hiring. I believe we have a ton in our East Valley right now at our Scottsdale and Tempe offices. We also hire in the West Valley and Surprise in those areas as well. So I always recommend keep an eye on our site, because if you go on there and you see something, that's not really fitting what you're looking for or interested in, I guarantee you we're going to have something probably open up within the next day or next week. We're constantly putting our jobs out there. As I had kind of put on here, our site is, it's easy to navigate. It's super user-friendly. We updated it a few years ago to make sure that it was user-friendly. So once you apply, the great thing is you're going to create your profile. You're going to upload your resume. You can upload a cover letter. It's not necessarily required, but maybe you want to add a little bit extra depending on the job that you're applying for. Once you create your profile and get your information on there, you don't have to do it every single time. Then from there, you'll go and you can apply to jobs. So just get your profile on there, and any job opening that you see you're interested in, you're just going to apply and you can use that same profile. It's super easy. You're going to click on there. You're going to go to the current opportunities at the top of the menu, and then you'll scroll down and you're going to specifically select the Department of Transportation to find all of our job openings. And then the thing that I like to point out is there's always going to be a closing date on that job. It's something you really want to pay attention to, because once that job closes, if you don't apply before the deadline, and usually the deadline is going to be on that day at 11:55 p.m. So right before midnight is when our jobs close. Once it closes, it's going to get taken down and you're not going to be able to apply unless for some reason we reopen it, which does happen. But we have so many opportunities. We actually had an IT that was just added. I think I saw somebody interested potentially in IT opportunities. We have customer service. We actually have one of my positions open in my department that we are hiring for. We do try to promote hybrid work. As you can see, you can probably see from my background, I do work from home. So we definitely have opportunities to work from home. The one thing I will point out for those customer service rep, obviously you're going to be in those MBD offices. So that one will require you to be in the office 5 days a week. But we offer flexibility with schedules. We have a great pension opportunity here working for the state. We get all those wonderful state holidays off. All of our positions are standard Monday through Friday. You can have flexibility on kind of the times you work depending on what the department needs are and working with your manager. For some of our transportation construction tech jobs, we do offer actually 4/10. So you'll work Monday through Thursday, 10-hour days. Again, that's something you can discuss with your manager and they can work with you on. And then the one requirement for all of our positions across the board is we're obviously the Department of Transportation, right? So we need a valid driver's license. Even if you're out of state, that's not a problem. We can work on, you know, when obviously moving into Arizona, if you decide to transfer, you're gonna need to get an Arizona license anyways, right? But if you're working 100% remote for any of our opportunities and you're out of state, that's not a problem. We obviously, you know, can offer flexibility and work with you on that. Other than that, anytime you look at our job, if you're wondering, you know, what are the requirements, what's the pay, all those details are going to be listed on each of our requisitions. We have listed the requirements, and then we also have what we call our selected preferences. So I always tell everyone, those are, it would be nice for you to have, but it's not necessarily required. So if you go on there and you see something listed under selected and you don't necessarily have it, don't let that discourage you from applying. Still apply, it's not required. The only thing you're gonna have to pay attention to is our pre-employment requirements. And like I said, honestly, 90% of those are just gonna be having a valid driver's license. But I can tell you, it's a great place to work for. I've been here a few years now, made a huge change after my previous job I was at for 10 years. And unfortunately it was during COVID, I got laid off. So I understand and I get it. Especially after 10 years, it was really scary. And I found a wonderful place to work with ADOT, but it really motivates me to want to help people find jobs, you know, and really find a career in what you're looking for. So please feel free to reach out to me. If you go to the next slide, I do have my contact information for you. So there's my phone number and my email. I always tell everyone it's best to get in touch with me by email. That way, you know, because I have my phone with me, but I go to a lot of events and I'm out of the office here and there. So email's the best way. I'm constantly checking it. You can also call me, leave a message if I don't pick up, and I'll absolutely give you a call back. But I look forward to speaking with you guys all in the breakout rooms, and I appreciate you having me here today.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Vanessa. I love the flexibility that the state of Arizona has incorporated. And also, ADOT has to be in the running for the best signs, freeway signs out there. They have to be.
We do contests and have like the employees and even have, we actually have a calendar contest as well where we incorporate kids and nephews and anyone under like the age of 10 and they contribute to a calendar each year and we publish the calendar. So we have a lot of fun stuff to try.
Oh, that's so fun. I love that. Yeah, if you haven't, if you're outside of Arizona, next time, if you ever get here, make sure to read the signs as you're driving around. They're pretty fun. So thanks so much, Vanessa. Appreciate you being here. All right, we're going to move over to Dexcom now. And we actually have Sandy Lopez is on the line, but we actually have Ashley Bauer. She is the senior recruiter and she's going to be speaking today. So good morning, Ashley.
Good morning, Jessica. Thanks so much, guys, for having me today. And thanks for being here. I can first kind of just hop into tell you a little bit about myself and the company itself, and then we'll dive into the positions that we have available. So I'm Ashley Bauer. I'm one of the senior recruiters here at Dexcom. I've been here for, it'll almost be 3 years, but also supported Dexcom from a staffing agency. I was previously at AeroTech that I supported them for the last 4 years previous. So I actually was the on-site manager, sat on site at Dexcom and just really grew to love their culture and what this company is about. So made the transition just almost 3 years ago. But I'll first dive into a little bit about what is Dexcom, who we are, what we're doing, and then we'll go from there. So Dexcom is a global leader in continuous glucose monitoring systems for people with diabetes. So our revolutionary devices provide real-time data on glucose levels, enabling individuals to manage their condition more effectively and make more informed decisions about their health. Our mission is simple yet profound, to empower people to take control of their diabetes and truly live life to the fullest. So behind every Dexcom device that changes lives is a dedicated team of professionals working diligently in our manufacturing facilities. These individuals are at the heart of our operation, ensuring that the technology we develop reaches the hands of those who need it the most. Our manufacturing positions play a vital role in our mission. And here's a few reasons why you should consider joining our team here at Dexcom. Impactful work. Working at Dexcom means you contribute to a larger purpose. improving the lives of millions living with diabetes. Your efforts directly impact people's health and well-being, creating a meaningful and rewarding career. Cutting technology, at Dexcom, you'll be at the forefront of medical technology. Our manufacturing processes involve state-of-the-art equipment and the latest advancements in the field, allowing you to continuously learn and grow as a professional. We have collaborative environment. We value collaboration and teamwork. You'll be part of a diverse and inclusive workforce that encourages creativity, innovation, and the exchange of your ideas. Your contributions will be recognized and celebrated as we work together towards our common goal. This is a huge one, is personal growth. Dexcom is not, you know, just a job. It's a platform for personal and professional growth. We offer diverse training, development opportunities, and career pathways that allow you to expand your skills and climb the ladder within the organization. Industry leader, by joining Dexcom, you become a part of an industry leader that is shaping the future of healthcare. Your role in our manufacturing process directly contributes to our continuous innovation and the advancements we bring to the market. So as you guys explore the job fair today, I encourage you to learn more about Dexcom. Hop into one of myself's or Sandy's breakout rooms to learn a little bit about our manufacturing positions. Thank you. And then the next slide here kind of goes into a little bit about what we currently have opening. We have over 100 positions out here in Mesa, Arizona. So we have two locations here. We are off of Broadway and Dobson in Mesa. And then we have our warehouse. It's about a 500,000 square foot facility. We opened up just about 2 years ago out there in East Mesa. We're right off of Ray in the 202. So lots of opportunities. We are continuously growing, not only locally, but globally as well. We are in Malaysia opening up our third manufacturing facility as well. So lots of opportunities to grow locally and globally. But as you can see here, we have all different levels of manufacturing associates. We have levels 1 through 3 that we're really hiring as we speak. We just in January got FDA regulated to release our new G7 product line. So we've just seen, you know, significant growth with that and continue to grow internally as that G7 rolls out. But as our manufacturing associates, we do work 12-hour days. So it is 3 days on, 4 days off 1 week. And then the next week you'd work 4 days on, 3 days off. I can kind of go into it if you want to, you know, learn a little bit about more about that schedule in the breakout rooms. I'll break it down of how that works. So anywhere from entry level positions to, you know, our level 3, we do have after that our leads, supervisors, managers as well. We have our quality team out here in Mesa as well. So quality insurance inspectors, QA, QCs. And then we also have our collaboration technicians and equipment technicians. So there's a little QR code there that you are able to go straight to our Dexcom site for all the listings of our positions that we have available. Just like everyone, we continue to grow and it changes on a daily basis. So if you want to jump to the next slide here, this is going to be my contact information and Sandy's contact information. So feel free to reach out to us if you see something on, you know, our website that you're interested in. And we're happy to help navigate you to that right recruiter as well. We also have exciting news that we have an actual job fair tomorrow as well. It's actually going to be on site at our Broadway and Dobson location. We are hiring anyone that has manufacturing experience, any type of supervisor experience. And I can go in the breakout rooms a little bit more of what we're looking for, but feel free. This is a QR code right here that I'll also drop in the chat for you guys to register for the job fair. We are requiring each candidate to register for the job fair just to get a pulse of how many candidates we'll be expecting. But it is tomorrow from 3 p.m. to 6:30 p.m. We are a 24/7 run operation here at Dexcom, so our lines do not go down. So we do have day shifts and night shifts available for you. I would say if you're looking for more of a day shift, maybe come around right at that 3-4 o'clock time. And then if you are looking looking for a night shift. Our supervisors come in right around 4:35. So maybe come and head in right around that time. But looking forward to connecting with you guys. And if you have any questions, feel free to drop them in the chat. And excited to hear more about all the other companies as well. So thanks so much, Jessica.
Awesome. Great job, Ashley. And again, if you haven't used a QR code before, all you do is just take your phone and on the picture in your photo view and scan that QR code, click it, it'll go straight to the URL to register. So, and that facility right off the 202 looks beautiful. I've never been inside it, but I saw it going up because I drive past it all the time. Yeah. And so it looks like a fantastic facility out there.
It is. And it definitely is. I appreciate that.
Awesome. All right. We're going to move over to Denise Gredler. I mentioned Denise at the beginning of this call because Denise is the one that I called in a panic 14 years ago where I needed help as I launched Career Connectors. And this is what Denise is one of the most connected people in Arizona to employers, and her organization, Best Companies AZ, helps work with companies that are award-winning companies and best places, most admired companies to work for. And she's got a slew of them she's going to talk about, but she has some really great opportunities with some of these companies, and she is going to talk about them. So Denise Gredler is a CEO and founder and one of my best friends personally. She's with Best Companies. Hi, Denise.
Hi, thank you, Jessica. Actually, I love hearing Jessica's story. 14 years ago, I've been in business 22 years, but 14 years ago, that was the best year. That's when we really started to do things at Best Companies AZ, and my passion and mission for what we do came to life. So thank you, Jessica, for inviting me out today. I'll give you just a quick high-level overview of Best Companies AZ. We are a regional employer branding firm, and we specialize in identifying and promoting the best companies in Arizona. But for anybody that is not in Arizona on the line, this is an event for you too, because almost every single company that we vote a best place to work in Arizona, they do have a national footprint. Here is a picture of our homepage. You'll see the QR code at the top. If you want to take a quick picture of that, that will take you out to our subscribe page, and you'll be able to get our weekly e-news and social media. We're very engaged on social media, and we're always pushing out job leads and best slips. So the next slide, Bree, what you'll see, one of the things a lot of people ask me is how do you determine who the best companies are? Is this just like a Denise best list? And no, it is not a Denise best list. If you look here, you'll see all of our clients that we either feed. We have about 20 clients that we feature, plus we have lists that we feature. And all of them have some sort of credible award. And you just look across the first line there. These are some national awards, Fortune World's Most Admired, Companies That Care, a lot of companies here in Arizona that are Great Place to Work certified, and then Fortune, Best for Women, Best for Millennial, Best for all different types of diversity. Across the bottom line, you'll see other awards for World's Most Ethical Companies, Disability Equality, LGBT Equality. And the two awards that we manage here in Arizona, the one on the left, Arizona Most Admired Companies, and the one on the right, Top Companies, we just announced the 2023 lists that are on our website. So you join us in the breakout room, and I'll take you out to take a peek at them. So these are lists that are generated by an employee survey. So the employees truly are voting these companies a best place to work. And I think Dexcon, I've seen you on a couple of these best lists. So kudos to you for your amazing culture. Okay, but today I'm here to talk about the next slide, Bree. You'll see we have about, like I said, about 18 or 20 companies that we represent every year, where you go out to our website and you'll see a company profile. But four companies that I want to talk about today in the breakout room that fit the transportation and warehousing industry is Axon. I think many of you may know of Axon as the taser company. They have a mission to protect lives, and they are headquartered in Arizona and have a manufacturing facility with a variety of different supply chain and quality assurance type jobs that I could share with you. The next couple over, you'll see WillScot Mobile Mini. They're another one. They are a global, they're actually a national provider of portable solutions. and they recently were just certified as a great place to work. They have jobs, just glancing here, service yard technicians, setup technicians, driver apprentice. So I could share a little bit about those jobs and their culture. And then we have two nonprofits on here. You'll see Donor Network and then Habitat for Humanity. They both just were named a top company to work for here in Arizona. And as a nonprofit, being on a top company to work for list is very impressive. They also, I know Donor Network does have drivers. They transfer organs or organ donations. So it's a very, very important position. And then Habitat for Humanity has a restore where they have drivers. So I would be happy to meet with anyone in the breakout room to talk about any of these companies. And then I could even hop over to our awards tab, Jessica, and just show them some of the recent lists where they could even skim through some of the companies that will be in this vertical of transportation and manufacturing, transportation. So with that, I'm going to stop there and invite people to come and meet me in the breakout room.
Denise, I did not know that about the Donor Network. Wow, what a worthy cause. That's amazing.
Yeah, they have a lot of great positions open, actually, if anybody is interested in getting into the nonprofit world.
Awesome. Well, thank you. Thanks so much for being here and presenting today. I really appreciate you. And Denise is available in the breakout room. You can ask her questions in the chat. She, again, is very well connected and it just has a heart of gold. So thanks again, Denise, for being here.
Thank you.
All right, you guys, we are going to move over to Dover Food Retail. It's an AMS group company, and we have Macy Manning as the speaker today. Good morning, Macy.
Good morning. Thanks for having us. We're really excited to be here. So I'll jump right in and introduce myself. I'm Macy. I'm the HR generalist here at the AMS group. I'll first kind of go over our organization. It is a little complex, so I'll just give you a breakdown so you do have an understanding. The AMS group, we are part of a bigger organization named Dover. It's an $8 billion organization. And our, so from Dover, that's our parent company. And then our operating company is Dover Food Retail. And within Dover Food Retail, there is a few segments. Dover Food Retail has Anthony, which they're the glass doors on refrigeration cases. Hill Phoenix is the manufacturer of all cases. And then we have the AMS group, and we are not a manufacturer organization. We are a project management. So we have individuals across the US that do condensers, conversion, and then refurbishments on cases in racks. And then we also have service. So that's local to Arizona. So they do service on any cases that are down. And it's not just our cases, Hill Phoenix and Anthony. It can also be our competitors like Hussman and so on. And then lastly, we have the local construction team. And they're across Nevada, New Mexico, and Arizona. And we help with any remodels or any new supermarket refrigerations or banana ripening rooms, which I didn't even know those were a thing. So we do some pretty cool things within that. Do you want to head to the next slide for me? Awesome. So our organization is growing rapidly. The AMS group, when I first started, I think was at 90 or so individuals, and right now we're at 130. And that's within the last year. So we've been growing rapidly. And with that, we are growing our warehouse. So I have James on the call here too. He's going to help out in the breakout rooms as he manages more of the warehouse. And so any specific questions of the warehouse or things like that, he will be in the breakout rooms to assist with that. But our warehouse group, we are expanding the parts. And so when we go to these job sites, we need the parts to fix all of these things or even build them. And so with that, you would be working with the project coordinators to make sure that what is needed for parts is in order and out to the job site at the specific time, as everything is on a strict timeline. So we're looking for somebody that has great communication skills and that you would also have the ability to drive. So you need a valid driver's license and drop off certain items across the valley. And then it's also critical to have somebody who is organized and is attention to detail, as these parts are pretty expensive and sometimes they're tiny. And so making sure you have all the right things to build what is needed is critical. The other thing I want to go over quickly, just so you are aware of some of the culture things that we have here, due to us being part of a bigger organization like Dover, we have amazing benefits. So we have 11 paid holiday, 40 hours of sick leave, and then 80 hours of PTO on top of that. Medical, dental, and vision actually start on day one, which is fantastic. 401k has company match, up to 6% day one, and then short-term and long-term disability are also covered through our organization. We have parental leave and then educational assistance also offered after 6 months. So they have great employee assistant programs as well that are no cost to you. So legal assistant, tax questions, therapy, life coaching, and so much more. So I really like to say, we are definitely a big family at the AMS group. We think it's really, really important, you know, to understand those things. So we like to put on day-to-day events as well. The last one I just put on was wing sauce competition, and whoever won got a gift card to Wingstop. The last one we had was salsa competition, and they got some tacos to go buy for their family after that. So we like to keep it fun and make sure everyone has a good time, and it, you know, helps the work environment as well. So if you want to head to the next slide, I have put all of our contact information. Again, my name is Macy Manning. Cheryl is my boss. She is not on today. She's the other HR individual at the AMS group. And then, like I said, James is on as well, and he can answer any of those warehouse questions. And then Jenny is his supervisor, and Jenny is not on either, but there is her contact information. I'll also put in the chat our inventory control clerk position that's open. We do have, I think, 32 openings right now, so check them out. Again, those might not all pertain to you, as we do have project managers across the organization. And like I said, we are expanding our warehouse, so I would expect in the next few weeks or so, having a few more warehouse positions as well. So look forward to connecting with you guys. If you have any questions, please let us know. More than happy to answer anything you may have.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Macy. Great job, and thanks for being here today. Okay, so real quick, I did want to mention to you guys that before we go into the breakout session here in about a half hour, maybe not that long, but in a few minutes, we will be giving away two Amazon gift cards. And so hang on, and you will see how we do that in just a little bit. So be ready for that. And I want to introduce you to our next speaker, Daria Orozco, she's a franchise owner with Express Employment Professionals, and she will explain this, but they are a staffing firm. If you do not have a relationship with a couple staffing firms, I highly, highly encourage that, especially ones that are in your industry, because they always know what's coming, who's hiring, and what's on the horizon. So Daria, welcome. I'm so glad you're here today.
Thanks so much, Jessica. So I'm with Express Employment Professionals. Our company is celebrating 40 years in business this year, and our office in South Phoenix has been here for 20 years. So we're well-established, well-connected, and here to help you find an immediate position and or a career opportunity. We handle temporary and long-term positions. You can go to the next slide. We have various opportunities and divisions. We have recruiters in each division. So we handle office services positions, light industrial, skilled trades, and professional. Office services are customer service, receptionist, administrative. Light industrial is more entry level skill set at picking and packing, assembly, general labor. Our skilled trades positions require a little bit more experience. So forklift operators, drivers, shipping and receiving clerks, welders, those types of skilled positions. And then finally, our professional division. So we handle anything from an accounting, accounts payable individual in the industry to HR managers, and also higher level supervisors, managers, and professionals as well. You can go to the next slide. This is a list of our immediate long-term opportunities. And by long-term, they're not long-term temporary. They are long-term permanent opportunities. The majority of our positions with our client companies are evaluation hire, where the company is looking to hire a permanent person. So they're looking to us as an arm of their human resources department to help them with the screening of candidates and the coordination of the interviews and placement of those individuals. The benefit to you in this situation is that it gives you a chance to have access to many, many different companies within our area. We handle South Phoenix, but our company has 7 other offices within the area, within the Phoenix metropolitan area. So when you're applying with Express Employment Professionals, it's like applying for hundreds of different companies all at one time. You have access to those opportunities, and we'll talk to you, our recruiters will talk to you about which opportunities fit you best. So under the light industrial area, we have a warehouse assembly opportunity. We have a warehouse opportunity in the industrial hardware industry. We have several production openings with a PVC pipe manufacturing company that's located in the Tolleson area, West Phoenix. Entry-level opportunities, packing for a vitamin manufacturer here in Phoenix. There isn't any experience required, just the willingness to be reliable, be on time, and learn the position. Then in our skilled trades area, right now we're looking for a reach operator in a milk warehouse located in Central Phoenix. That's a second shift position. We do also, I believe, have a first shift position in that type of role as well. We have a cherry picker opportunity, several cherry picker opportunities actually on first and second shift. That's at a warehouse and on the west side. We're looking for a material handler for a metal distributor here in the Phoenix area. That is various positions, so first, second, and third positions they offer. And finally, we have a pipe shop opportunity that's for a plumbing distributor. That's an outdoor position. It's covered, but it is outdoors, so we need someone who can be in the elements, and that's starting around 18 an hour. These positions are what we had open a couple of days ago. I believe several of them are still open and available. And our jobs are changing every single day. So we get new opportunities with client companies. All of the jobs that we have open, the companies are looking for people to start immediately. So when we're interviewing you and presenting you to the client company, we want you to be prepared to start that week. A lot of times there is not a long hiring process because our intention is to fill these jobs immediately for our client companies. So they are positions where you're offered benefits through Express Employment Professionals. We do have medical benefits that are not a major medical plan, but they are coverage to help you through that timeframe while you're getting hired onto the company. Benefits to you and also working through these positions is that if the job is not working out, if it's not a long-term fit for you, you can contact Express Employment Professionals. Give us some notice and we can find a new opportunity for you within the companies that we work with. You can go to the next slide.
This is the last slide. I only had gotten to 3. Sorry.
Okay. I can put my information into the chat box, and the best way to reach out and apply for these positions is to give our office a call. We also take walk-ins, so stopping by our office is on 32nd Street and Broadway. Our jobs are from 48th Street to about 75th Avenue and south of Van Buren, so in the South Phoenix area and also Ahwatukee. We also have 7 Valley offices around the Phoenix metro area. So I'll include a link to our website that shows you all of the locations that you can reach out to the location that's closest to you. Thank you so much. Awesome.
Thank you so much, Daria. So again, just be looking in the chat for their direct contact information. She's going to put that in there to the job board. And again, I encourage you, if you do not have a relationship with some staffing firms, they're a great one. We've been working with Daria probably, 8, 9, 10 years now, I think.
Yeah, long time.
Yeah, they're legit. They know what they're doing and they can help place you in some great jobs. So thank you so much for being here. All right, I'd like to introduce you all to Raina Robb next. She is the Southwest Region Recruiter for Sun State. Welcome, Raina.
Hi, thank you guys. Thanks for being here. So as a company, we rent out construction equipment. So anything you'd see on a construction job site, we're renting it. And a lot of times our drivers will be taking it out to job sites, delivering it, picking it up. So kind of a difference from a lot of the over-the-road positions that you may be seeing out there. If you do have a CDL, you will be able to get in and out, stay active, get things loaded and strap down the equipment. So we're kind of looking for someone who's looking to do that. And all of our positions are local, so you do get to be home every night. No long-term over the road away from family. We do have locations across the country. So the two we'll kind of cover here are out of Arizona, but if you are looking to relocate, that's a good option to maybe start here in Arizona, and you can always go to other locations. We're really good about working with you for career development opportunities or whatever that means to you. We've had people kind of go into different things. So if you do want that career growth, career movement, that's definitely an option out there. So we do have these two positions on the screen, one in the East Valley and then a couple in the West. So lots of things. Like I know a lot of the others have said that the positions do change pretty quickly. So if you don't see it now, it may be up later. These ones are moving quickly too. So I'd encourage you to get in quickly on those. But, and I know some of you are also interested in maybe like operations manager position or something else. So if you're maybe not looking to start out as a driver and can maybe have some of that experience already, we do have a couple positions, one in Texas, one in San Jose. So definitely if you're willing to relocate, there are some other opportunities for operations managers as well. And the next slide, we'll just have contact information. So like I said, take a look at our website, see what's available. It's kind of constantly changing. And with our positions too, they're going to be typically Monday through Friday, usually work in some overtime, but we do pay time and a half for overtime. Full benefits, medical, dental, vision, and 401k company match. So a lot of the benefits that you'd see at a larger company we're able to offer, but still kind of have that smaller family feel of getting a chance to, you know, get to know each other, a lot of team building events, and really close-knit at a lot of the branches here. So a lot of great opportunities, and I look forward to seeing you guys in the break room or breakouts.
Awesome. Thank you so much, Raina. Appreciate you being here and offering up your opportunities. Okay, I have a question in the chat I just wanted to address. Somebody said, hey, will we get a chance to have a list of employers that are hiring? Yes, for anyone that was registered for this event, which would be definitely everybody on the call plus more, you are going to get an email. The email usually comes out the same day. Sometimes it's the next morning, but it's a list of all the companies that are here with a direct link to their job board. It is also a link directly to this webinar. So you can go back and look at anything you want to look at. And that is the piece that sometimes takes a little bit of time to upload. And so, but it'll definitely be up by tomorrow morning. So yes, you will get an email with the links to employers, with the link to the webinar, and then a whole bunch of resources. And so, that's great information or great resource for you. So be looking for that. All right. I'd like to introduce you all to Dania Diaz. She is a talent acquisition specialist with Benchmark. Hi, Dania.
Hi, good morning. So I am the recruiter for Phoenix location. We do have three sites in Arizona. So we have Tempe, Mesa, and Phoenix. I'm 3 minutes drive from the Phoenix Sky Harbor Airport. Actually, out of my office window, I can see planes, you know, flying out every day. So super close to the airport, just to give you commute. So what I do here, I hire for all of our full-time regular positions. We have about 193 employees at the Phoenix site. And I always like to start off my conversations with who is Benchmark or what do they do? So essentially they're a supplier for Intel, Honeywell, Boeing, Raytheon, just to name a few of our clients. And we are supplying them with electronics manufacturing. So we are a printed circuit board assembler. So we have assembly lines full of millions of dollars worth of machinery that basically assembles products for those big company names that I'm sure you guys have heard of. So I like to let everybody know we've been around for 44 years on this year. We actually moved corporate headquarters to Tempe, right at Tempe Marketplace in 2017, which is really cool because it is a global company. So they have 24 facilities in 8 different countries. They made about $2.89 billion in revenue last year, and we have about 13,500 employees or so. And I always like to inform them just so you guys have a bigger idea of like how big or small, I mean, in comparison to other manufacturers we are. So what we do, we lead on the global side with outsourcing design engineering. So what that is basically when Intel or Honeywell or any company that is in the manufacturing space comes to us and they're like, hey guys, we want to build or modify one of our products. Can we meet with your design engineers? They meet with them, they come up with the prototype and then they sign a contract with us. And then that's how we get their business. And then that's how we manufacture the product if they want that service. Next slide, please. Awesome. So here's a quick glance at our open position. So we hire material handler positions, which is a little bit more like a pick place. So you guys are essentially opening up the product. It's like a stock room position, in lack of a better word. So pick place. So you're kind of setting up the assembly boards. So they go out to the assembly lines in the morning. So we have two different shifts. We either have the morning shift. So that's a Monday through Friday from 6 a.m. to 2:30 p.m. There's a 30-minute lunch break, or second shift Monday through Friday from 1:30 to about 10:30, 11 p.m. at night. And that is also Monday through Friday. We do have the occasional overtime or weekends, which we also pay overtime for. That is all dependent on client need and also how many people we need to hire for positions. For most part, I keep my stock room fully staffed. Right now we have these two openings, which you guys could go to by clicking on the QR code or kind of placing your phone over the QR code. Something great about working at Benchmark is that all my leaders talk to me on a daily basis. So actually a minute before stepping into this call, I had my director of supply chain step in, just since I told him I was going to be talking about his jobs, and he offered to sit in with me at the breakout rooms. The great part about that is just kind of building that trust, that FaceTime with the leadership of the organization. So you guys get to see firsthand, ultimately who you would be reporting into, even though it might be a supervisor manager role that you're reporting into, it all rolls up to my director, who is very hands-on with all of my hiring needs. So that's a little special treat for you guys if you want to join me during the breakout sessions, since he'll talk more on the day-to-day. He did inform me they typically do a 90-day training onboarding plan for all their new hires, which would get you guys like up to speed. So it's not necessarily like, you know, foot in the door, like hit the ground running, like you're actually eased into the role specifics. Something else that he told me is regarding the specialty material just because it does have to, it's like sensitive, like temperature, because this printed circuit boards are anti-static. So we have to use certain product to saran wrap it or bubble wrap it. So it's a really different process. It's not your standard warehouse that we do here, because our product is extremely expensive. I mean, like one of the parts to fix one of these machines could be anywhere from $20,000 to $50,000. So I just want to kind of like reiterate that it is a little bit different than your typical warehouse. Sometimes our folks have to wear bunny suits. So, you know, like the full mask, the full like suit, just in order to touch these printed circuit boards so then they can go to the customer or a different supplier to kind of finish the manufacturing piece of it all. So that's my whole spiel. Thank you so much for being here and I appreciate your time.
Great job. Thanks so much. We appreciate you. So a lot of great positions, you guys. We're getting ready to go into the breakout sessions. I have some resources for you and I want to give away a couple gift cards. So first of all, what I want to do now is we are going to give away two $50 Amazon gift cards. We're going to give away one on the call right now, and then we're going to give another one away. It'll be after the call, just giving people some time to complete the survey if they haven't. But what I want you to do is Bree is going to drop the survey link into the chat. Click on that survey and go out and take it real quick. So we want some feedback from you on the companies here, and we are collecting information to submit for our grant. So we're on a grant with this program. It's ending, and we're going out to try to renew it so we can provide more hiring events. And so if you could click on that link, go out, fill the survey out. It's only a couple questions. It'll take you less than a minute. And then when you're done with that, come back to the chat and type in done. So when you get done with the survey, come back and type in done, and we will make sure that we announce the Amazon gift card winner, one of them here, and then we're going to give away another one later today when our assistant gets here, when our admin gets here. And we had a couple winners last time. I just was notified by one of them. He hasn't got his gift card, but that's because our admin was out on an emergency medical leave, but she's back today. So you will be getting your gift card via text. And once you respond to that, then we will give you the link to go get your gift card. So thank you. So click that link, go out, take the survey, and then click done. And somebody on my team will be texting me in a few minutes to tell me who won so I can announce it. All right. Now, there are a couple additional resources. First of all, we are all over social media, and we would love to connect with you on LinkedIn. We also are on Instagram, Facebook, and even TikTok. And so check us out there, connect with us. We're trying to get out good information on career transition, job opportunities, things like that. We also have a DISC assessment that is free to you guys. And so free to go ahead and click on the DISC link, which will be in your email also. Free to click on that and get your assessment. It will come out with a really good report of about 24 pages. It has information on your ideal work environment, communication strengths, things like that. And then again, all of our webinars that we've been doing the last couple of years are posted online. And so you can check those out. That link will also be in your email that's coming. All right. And we talked about the next couple slides are around Best Companies AZ. Again, Denise is on the line. She's in a breakout room and she is available to talk to you about these companies that are hiring. You guys, we just announced a really cool thing on Thursday, and I wanted to let you know that it is happening. We have a previous employee, her name is Sheila Coulomb, and she was wonderful in helping build Career Connectors and bringing it to where it is today. We are offering up a $3,000 education scholarship in her name, and she is all about education. And so that press release will be coming out Monday. And so watch for that announcement and please apply for that. If you have some type of education certification program, if you're going for a degree, if you need some training, whatever it is, you can apply for this. It'll be a short application process. I think it's you fill in a couple cells on a form, name, email address, and you give us a paragraph on why you're interested. And then we'll choose a winner within the next couple weeks after that. We'll give you the deadlines. And then we're going to offer a $3,000 scholarship. So we're so excited about that, you guys. Thank you for dropping done in the chat. I'll have a winner here in just a few minutes. All right, we also have a really cool program with an organization called LearnKey, and they do online certifications, online trainings, and they are offering a couple free trainings. So we wanted to get those out to you guys. They're one of the premier global training organizations around. They're online training opportunities. And so when people go through these different programs, they have a very high percentage of higher pay and higher job landings. And so I am excited to let you guys know that the two training classes they're offering for free. One is around cybersecurity. So even if you're not interested in cybersecurity, this one is a really great opportunity because it's about protecting yourself as well, but protecting yourself and your organization. And then this is so important, building trust and credibility. That is a soft skill. I was in a board meeting last week and our board members were talking about hiring and some data that we're seeing from workforce professionals and employers. And of the top skills that employers are looking for, more than half had to do with soft skills, communication, integrity, building trust, things like that, navigating the system, critical thinking. And so we thought, well, what can we do to offer up some training around that area? And so that's, we were already partnering with LearnKey and they said, let us provide one of the soft skills. And so building trust and credibility. And Bree is going to go ahead and drop that link in, as well as you will see it on the email that's coming. All right, upcoming events. We have one of our annual best events coming up on Thursday, September 7th, and that is Red Hot Resumes. The cool thing, we do this event twice a year because it's so popular. The cool thing about this event is that we bring in professional certified resume writers, ones that know how to get through the applicant tracking system, ones that really know what your resume needs, how it should be formatted, and how to incorporate keywords, how to fill out accomplishment statements. They know what it needs. They also know what it doesn't need. And I know we all have opinions on resumes and we ask a whole bunch of people to look at our resume. Is it right? Does it done well? I'm telling you guys, these are the people to listen to. They know what they're doing. They've been writing resumes for each of them over 20 years and they keep up. They're certified annually, annual process to be certified. So I'm encouraging you to be there on Thursday, September 7th. And then we have an in-person Career Expo on Thursday, September 28th in Avondale. So if you're in the West Valley, I encourage you to join us. We already have 20 companies booked for that. I imagine it'll grow to 30 before the event. So lots of great opportunities there. And then October 5th, we're doing one around LinkedIn. And so some great stuff going on. All right, we have a winner. Let me see, my team sent me a text. All right, are you guys ready? The winner for the Amazon gift card is Amber Farber. Yay, Amber, we are going to send you a text message. It is not spam. It's a real message that you are getting a real gift card. And so look for that. Again, it should be today when our admin comes in to the office, and then you will get that gift card. So also, we will be sending out one more gift card. It just gives anyone else that hasn't completed the survey a few more minutes. So if you get a text from some random person today and it says you won a $50 Amazon gift card, it's real. It's not spam. It's real. And so answer us so we can get it to you. It's crazy how hard it is to give away these gift cards sometimes. So make sure you answer us. All right. Let's see. I think that is my list for today. Bree is going to walk us through the breakout room. So now is your time to engage with employers. And I just want you all to know that we are praying for you, that you all land into the career of your dreams. Thank you so much for being here today. I am Bree. Off to you.
All right, so in just a moment, I'm going to open up all the breakout rooms. So it'll be a list of all the companies you heard from today. So once I open them here in just a second, you will be able to go and click on breakout rooms in your toolbar. You'll see a list. You're going to hover over those companies, and to the right, you'll see a blue button that says join. You can join into that breakout room, and the same way you went into one is the same way you would go into another one or come back to the main session. So I'm opening all the rooms right now. If anyone needs any help getting into the breakout rooms, just let us know in the chat and we can manually move you over. Thank you.